Hey guys, welcome to the session on real-time analytics with MongoDB Change Streams. I'm Shreya Batra, lead for MongoDB user group here in Delhi NCR. I have been working with MongoDB for over 5 years, and today I'll be showcasing you guys how to design real-time analytics. So before we start, I want to ask all of you guys a few questions. Have you ever built a system to calculate some metrics for a single user? Maybe count of entities, average of some ratings, or just the top popular reviews? Obviously, there are just different types of queries. If yes, I have another question for you. Now, have you ever built the same system for a million users? Did your query scale, or did your application crash? Let's say you did handle them. Now, could you serve the million users millions of times a second? Too much load to handle, right? Yes, that is a scale of analytics we'll be handling all in real time. Before we begin, let's set out the agenda that we have for today. We will be learning what is real-time analytics. Then we'll be learning modeling high volume metrics. Then we'll be moving on to MongoDB Change Streams, showcasing a plug and play architecture. Then we'll see how to use MongoDB Atlas Triggers for our use cases. And finally, we'll solve a real life example of using all the techniques that we have seen. So the biggest question still remains, what is real-time analytics? Let's imagine a music streaming application where anyone can go in and listen to some customized music playlists. Now, as per any music streaming application out there, there could be many different custom playlists, such as top 10 tracks in a country by language, top 50 international tracks, users' most played tracks in the last 24 hours, or users' most favorite tracks in the last year. Let's see how the user events are coming into the system. Every time a user listens to a track, you make an entry into the system. Let's say user 1 is listening to track A at time T1 and location L1, which is of type relaxing and in English language. Now, user 2 comes in and his event pops up. And similarly, we have multiple users and events in the system. Each of these events would look something like this in our database and collection, having everything as key value pairs. Now, let's pick up a single use case and see how do we model a query for it. We'll pick up the use case of top 10 tracks of last 7 days for a particular language. So, how does your query look like? First, you filter all the events with the timestamp and language. Then you group by the track and find the count of each track. Then you sort them in descending order and pick the first 10, which will be your top 10, right? For people more familiar with the MongoDB aggregation pipeline, it will look something like this. We have the match stage corresponding to our filter stage, the group by the group aggregation stage with our group stage, and obviously the sort and the limit stages. So how do we solve this so that we have millions of queries per second? It's simple. We change the data model. And how do we do that? Let's go by adding a push-based system into our API layer. Let's see the different techniques that we have for that. The first technique, pre-computing metrics on generation. Let's say that we have to calculate total plays of each track in a week. How do we pre-calculate that? We actually calculate that as and when it happens and comes into the system in a separate document, in a separate collection. And saying for track A for India, we have a total of 560 plays till now. Now, whenever a user comes in, we just need to update this particular document. As you can see, we already have the answer for our use case as and when required. So no computation is actually needed at the time the result is needed from the system. Now, what happens when we can't calculate the exact answer beforehand? For that, we have a second technique, calculate immediate results. Let's say now we want to find the average rating of each track in a particular week. If we keep the average calculated at every instant, it will be very tough to recalculate whenever a new rating comes into the system. Instead of keeping the exact average calculated, we keep the bits and pieces required to calculate the average so that we can complete the equation as and when needed. So whenever a user comes in, we just recalculate those bits and pieces independently. And when we need the final answer, suppose the equation for average rating is total rating upon total users. So we just pick the intermediate results and find the actual answer we are looking for. Another optimization is a third technique, predefining the buckets or categories. Suppose the use case is to find total views by country. We already know which countries are there in the world, and we can predefine the number of objects or buckets we have in the system. Now, whenever a user comes in, we just tag that particular user to the appropriate bucket without any inconsistency, breaking our flow. And all the users coming in can be done accordingly. So, when we have our data modeling techniques, let's talk about some API integration challenges. What is the general application architecture? We have the users who query our application interface when browsing our application. The API interface then queries the MongoDB database to fetch some information and to record each event. Now imagine every use case of computing those customized playlists, we would have to write all our code directly into the API layer. What challenges would it offer us? The first is tight coupling. All the metrics, use cases, business logics would be tightly coupled with our API interface, and any one of the use case can lead to a full deployment of the API suite. The second is multiple implementations. If a use case has been implemented or defined in multiple services, then any change in the logic would have to be replicated across all the services, or else there would be inconsistency in the system. And the last challenge we can see is the time to ship. For any use case or logic change, it could be blocked by any type of delay in any other part of the API interface, right? So the question is, how do we deal with it? So let's introduce MongoDB Change Streams. MongoDB Change Streams can be viewed as a publisher for change events happening in any collection or database, to which we can subscribe and capture those change events. Let's see some advantages of using MongoDB Change Streams. The first is push-based events. Change events are pushed to the consumers at real time. The next is scalability. We can consume millions of events in real time capacity as and when the changes are going into the database. The third is the plug and play architecture. So any new use case can be developed and deployed independently and does not depend on any other code or service. Now let's see how our application architecture changes with MongoDB Change Streams. We have the users, they interact with the application interface to listen to the music. The application interface pushes the event to the MongoDB database. Now, rather than the API interface also updating and calculating the use cases, we have the MongoDB Change Streams emitting those events to a consumer. Now, what if we need to have multiple consumers, one per use case? Simple, we just plug more consumers to the MongoDB instance, connecting the change streams to each consumer, right? As simple as that gets. So now let's see, how do you define your MongoDB change streams code, right? So let's start by showcasing an example in JavaScript. So we start by connecting to our collection and then watching for any events in that collection. So as and when we get an event will occur, we can capture that event and apply the processing we need to do. Right? So what will happen in Python? Similarly, in Python, we can define the cursor to the collection and then just iterate over that cursor as and when any event happens, right? Now, sometimes we might want to listen to only certain type of events. How do we filter them? Do we define a pipeline which could have multiple stages of aggregation, such as $match stage, $add fields, etc. Once we have a pipeline, we can just pass that pipeline when we start watching any collection and then just iterate over that, right? As simple as that. Introducing MongoDB Atlas Triggers. What are MongoDB database Atlas Triggers? Atlas database triggers are nothing but managed change streams provided by MongoDB Atlas to us. How are they better than change streams? That is the question, right? So they are managed change streams, so no complex setup or code handling is required. All types of error handlings, crashes, logging, resuming the change streams after the crash are automatically handled by MongoDB Atlas triggers natively. And the third is, it is very easy to integrate MongoDB Atlas triggers via the Atlas UI. Let's see how you can create a MongoDB Atlas trigger, right? So let's come to the MongoDB Atlas UI and select the Triggers tab from the left side menu. Click on the Add a Trigger button. When you click on that, a form-based setup would come up and look something like this. Let's go over each thing one by one and see what is important for us. The first is the trigger type. For this presentation, let's just focus on database trigger type. Next is the event ordering. Ask yourself, do you want to process all the events in an orderly manner, or can you process them parallelly? Obviously, parallel processing would speed things up a lot. Next is for you to connect to the database and collection you want to hear the change events coming in from, right? The next thing is to select the type of changes you need to listen to. You can listen to one or more than one types of events, such as insert events, update events, delete events, or replace events, right? The next toggle is for full document, which says that do we need to return either only the change or the delta data, or do we need the whole full change document that we have in the collection? And the last is the server-side logic we need to define for our created trigger. Let's see an example of this later. So now, as we have defined our data models and application architecture, let's see them in action, right? So let's get back to our music streaming application. We saw that we had multiple use cases when we defined customized playlists for our user, right? So we had top 10 tracks, top 550 international tracks, users customized tracks, and users historical tracks, right? We also saw that we had multiple use cases that when we defined customized playlists for each other. We also saw that when any user started listening to any track, we had an event stored in our database, and we had multiple events, one per user, right? And these events were looking something like this in our database, right? Now, let's get back to our architecture and see where do we write our code. So we have the users, we have the API interface sending events into the MongoDB database. We have the MongoDB chain streams emitting these events to the consumer. Obviously, the consumer is where we are going to write our code, right? Now, assuming that we have already created a MongoDB Atlas database trigger looking for insert events into a collection, all that is left for us is to define the business logic for a use case. We'll do that by just defining the Atlas trigger function code to handle the function event captured. You remember we had the server-side logic or the function that we needed to implement? We'll just be doing that, obviously. So let's talk about top 10 tracks in a country by language, right? So we start by our function definition, where the change event is already being captured and sent to us by MongoDB Atlas. We extract the full document of the change event, and then we extract the user's country and language, all the information that we want for our processing. Next, we connect to our Atlas cluster and to that particular collection we want to add more information to, right? And we just do an update one, and we update the buckets of the user's language and country by incrementing the total hits by one. If this is the first time the document is getting updated, we would just create it by saying absurd equals to true, right? So just absurd, and all this is being handled. So every change event coming into our system is getting run, and these five lines of code is done, right? And that's it. We have successfully implemented a single use case by so little setup and code. That is the power of MongoDB change streams and ease of using MongoDB Atlas triggers. So to sum up, change the database models with the techniques we have learned. Use the MongoDB chain streams for independent deployment architectures, and use MongoDB database triggers to ease your use of chain streams, right? And that's how you can implement a real-time analytics for millions of users in a second without crashing your applications, right? Thank you, folks.